Hello everyone, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know about this channel and the video to max Excel function, watch the video till the end. And also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. So let's begin for today. We have a function that's called max function. Max function is basically, as we know, it's a statistical function. Max, min, median, mode, all of them are statistical functions. So we are going to learn this today in a much more deeper format. But before we begin on this, I would like you to understand a couple of the nitty-gritties about this topic. See, Excel function is basically categorized under the statistical function and in Microsoft Excel, and the Excel max function is used to find out the maximum value that is possible from a given set of data or probably an array. So max function in Excel, it returns the what we call as the highest value from given set of numeric numbers. Okay, see, Excel function formula will count numbers, but they ignore the what we call as the empty cells, text if there are any, the logical values like true and false, and text values, and so on and so forth. So Excel max formula can be used to calculate the highest salary of the employee, the fastest time score, the highest expense or the revenue amount, and so on and so forth. Now, how does this formula exactly work? See, if you write is equal to max and press tab button, you get two things. One is number, another one is again number two. So number one is the required number, and the optional parameter is the number two. It is basically the rest subsequent number that are optional. Now, how to use this max function in Excel? See, the max function in Excel is very simple and easy to use. Let's understand the working of max function by some example. The max formula in Excel can be used as worksheet and as a VBA function also. Well, today let's begin with the max function example over here. In this example, we have a student database with their score details, and now we need to find out the maximum score for the students. So here, apply the max formula in the Excel, saying is equal to max. Max what? Well, we'll have to select the whole database here. That will be C4, press tab. C4 to C19, close the bracket, we get 100 as the maximum answer. So 100 is a maximum score which is scored by Amit here. So we apply the formula here and we get the answer. So it will return you the max score, the given list of scores as shown in this above table. Now, in the second example, we have a student details with their score, but here some student did not have any score. Now apply max function in Excel. So we'll say is equal to max. Again, do G4 to G19. You will get 96 as the answer. So we have the highest value over here of Anuj as 96. So max function ignores, as we saw, the empty cells, and then calculates the max score from the given data as it is shown here in the table. Example number three, we have Tanuj, Dinesh, and so on and so forth. Somewhere we have written some text value. So suppose we have a student detail with the score, but for some of the students, score values are Boolean. So apply the max formula in the Excel over here as is equal to max, saying just select the whole thing, 94. See, so again here empty cell has also been not considered, also the text value has also been ignored here. So you can see the max function Excel ignores the Boolean value cells and then calculates the max score from the given data as shown over here, and we get the answer as 94. Now suppose we have a list of the names and we have to calculate the name with the maximum length. So LEN over here is the length formula that we have used. This is the length. So apply the max formula here and let's see what's the outcome. So that gives us 12 as the answer, as the length. Now max formula can also be used to find out the max date from the given set of the dates. and the maximum time from the given time and can be used to find the maximum currency from the given data over here as shown. So we have date here given 9/1/97 and so far over here time. So again we will use over here the max formula. So it says the maximum is the so the later date will be considered and is equal to max in terms of time, it will show us 4 a.m. Right. So after this, I want you to understand that there are some things that you should remember about the max function in Excel. Now see, max function through the values error, or if any of supplied values are, let's say, non-numeric, through the value error, if any supplied value is the non-numeric one. Second, max function in Excel will count the numbers, but they will ignore the empty cells. We have text, the logical values like true and false, and the text values. So if the max function does not have, let's say, any argument, let's say if it does not have any arguments, then it will return the value as zero as the output. Okay. So these are the couple of things that you should take in your brain before using this formula. The first one is, you know, the max function through the value error if any of the supplied values are non-numeric. Ignore, so the max functions ignore in the Excel will count numbers, but they will ignore the empty cells, text, the logical values, true and false, and the text values. And if the max function does not have any argument, then it will return the zero as the output. So this is the end of our topic. If you have loved and liked this video, then I would request you to subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below, and please like and comment on this video for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone.